we're looking at how to short the stock market. This is something that comes up all the time. And I wanted to kind of take a step back and look at like what the most rational and approachable way to short the stock market is out there. Because I think a lot of people look at shorting stocks as like something kind of like far away from them, like lofty and hard to do. And also like there's the unpatriotic part of it. And there's also the just like pessimistic view. But our viewpoint, especially in futures, is always that like there's two opportunities in every market, and it's long and short. And you have to pay the same amount for a long or a short position. And you have equal likelihood of both of them profiting around 50%. And also just like, since futures are a shorter term gig, it's not necessarily like I'm going to get short a stock future, Mikey, and hold it forever in the same way that people 10, 20 years ago bought Apple stock and they were like, I'm going to hold this forever. It doesn't have that same connotation shorting the stock market, especially at these inflated prices. I mean, what say you on the general idea here? Are you one of those people who are like, this is un-American, you can't be shorting stocks, this is wrong? It's just a different type of opportunity, right?
Yeah, I view it that you're like direction indifferent. I mean, if you want to profit from something going up or something going down, I don't really see a difference in that. But the great thing that futures afford you that you don't always find in outright stock shorts or even like buying puts is that futures cost the same to go long as to go short. And you're not dealing with things like put skew if you're trying to buy out of the money put options. And you're not dealing with hard to borrow or short sale restrictions when you're selling stock. It was always advertised to me as like this highly risky thing, it's like shorting stocks. But in the futures world, there's not really a difference between going long and going short.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And I'm glad that you brought up those other versions of like getting short, which would be, you know, buying a put, which everybody knows is a tough strategy in terms of probabilities. Everybody who's traded options, knows that like buying an out of the money put is one of the lowest probability things you could do when you're maybe betting on the stock market going lower or betting on a crash. Because you're going to pay for that premium, right? So not only does the stock market have to get down to that strike, but it has to get eclipse that strike and the money that you paid for that put. And if the crash doesn't occur tomorrow or next week or next month, you're going to have to keep re-upping and buying that put, buying that put, buying that put. It's all often likened to like, you know, this like bleeding out a slow death where it's like, I spent $5 on the put in August. I'm spending $5 in September, in October, November, December. The crash couldn't, it might not happen till 2022 or what have you. And the same with the short call. Now, the probability is in your favor there. But when you finally get that crash, Mikey, you lose the exposure like that. So futures, you know, they get away from those short selling restrictions you have in stock and ETF shares. They're less expensive than selling short in stock and ETF shares. They're equated the same level playing field as buying stocks is shorting stocks or selling stocks with futures. And it's funny because you and I do so much stuff for the small exchange. We do everything from this show to creating ad campaigns and email campaigns and all this different fun stuff. And one of the funny things, the inverse of this, like, oh, it's unpatriotic to sell stocks, is something we've been finding with our crude oil product, where a lot of people who subscribe to, I don't even have to be political about it. A lot of people who don't think that crude oil should be used because of its non-renewable nature and the future of our planet being up to question, there are like, why would you guys come out with this crude oil product? They think that you can only buy it. And it's like, you can sell that thing in the same way that you would buy it. And they're almost like it's unpatriotic to buy crude oil. And it's like, you could sell it and profit from it moving lower. So a lot of reasons why you would start out with futures when you're looking to short the stock market. But here's the thing, is that the market is up 30% here in 2021. And this is what we talk about when we say like, it's just another opportunity. Like in the same way that if corn prices skyrocketed 30%, like they have done several times in the last few months, you might look at selling that. Same with stocks here. The only problem is, Mikey, that it can get out of hand even with small stock futures to the tune of $1,500 here in 2021. That's a pretty big move and a lot of losses to be waiting on while you wait for that crash.
Yeah, and neat benefit to futures when you're trying to get short, because I feel this all the time, which is like the market is at an all-time high and I look at the world around us and the economy and I'm like, this thing has got to sell off. and if you're trying to do it with puts, it's so hard to time it. I mean, you're getting short exposure, but you already mentioned short put premium when you're buying put options or when you're selling calls, you're dealing with this as well. But also you have to time it so perfectly because each day data is chipping away at the value yep. of those options. So a beautiful kind of feature of the futures that they don't decay like options. So your timing doesn't have to be as impeccable or perfect. You can kind of maintain a short position, or you can roll it through time, or you can hold it for a day and take some profits on a bit of a sell-off. There's so much more you can do with the future sometime in its simplicity.
And that's a funny thing, because a lot of people who would prefer to buy the put as opposed to sell the future, which are both, I mean, let's call it what they are, leveraged ways to gain short exposure, mm-hmm. they would buy that put because they're like, oh, I don't want that infinite risk mm-hmm. To the upside if the stock market just moves higher. But I would contend that upward drift, the fact that the stock market does, you know, 54% of the time against a theoretical 50% of the time drift higher on a daily basis. And you can see this is drifting higher. Now it's $1,500 of drifting higher, which is a lot, but it's upward drift in the stock market until we see an inevitable crash. I would say that upward drift from a short futures perspective is the same as the long puts perspective on daily theta, right? Like a couple dollars come out of your long put position every single day, in the same way that a short futures position on average probably gives up a couple of dollars, probably around the same amount as that long put. So yeah, it's an interesting thing that you bring up there. And what is really nice about that futures is you hit on it, the exposure is consistent, right? Mm-hmm. Like there's no point with options. It can be tough because if I'm trying to get this exposure to a stock market crash with options, if it goes up by 30% and I just keep buying the same put down here, then I need it to collapse to where I started buying puts and then collapse even more before my exposure really kicks in. With futures, yes, you have that daily drift going against you, but once it starts crashing, and your exposure is 1-to-1 all the way mm-hmm. down. Now, something I wanted to present here, which is options into the short futures perspective on a stock market crash, Mikey, is combating that daily drift with a short put position and under hedging. So essentially, like, my idea is I think the stock market is going to crash. I want to get short the stock market. Futures present the best way to get consistent exposure to that without paying a bunch or worrying about some kind of regulation or your account not being able to sell stock short or having to pay for that privilege. Now, I like the idea of adding on a short put to this position to get that daily theta that we just talked about from the long perspective that kind of bleeds you out over time, to like combating that daily drift, getting that theta in your portfolio going in the positive direction. And I looked at just selling, if you sold a 70 cent put every month, you would have cut your losses in a stock market up 30% is way beyond an average year. So this is a pretty big outlier move, but you would have, you know, almost cut those losses in half, Mikey, right?
Yeah, I love this idea. This is the creativity in trading that is just so unique to options and combining it with futures. Very nice way to look at it. So what you have here is you're short the stock market, right? You want it to go lower, but you're selling put options against that position. Now, when you're selling a put, you're wanting that underlying to increase in price. So what you have is basically like a smaller short position. like you're, let's say you're short 100 deltas, you're selling that short put, let's say it's 20 deltas worth. So now you're short 80 deltas worth of exposure. A really neat way to maintain short exposure, but not be as overexposed. Now, can you walk me through here what would be like the worst case scenario in this position? So say you're short, but you're short your put, you rallied here, you know, you lost 1500 bucks, but you made your 560 from your short option. What about the other way? What if the thing crashes? Like, am I offset by my short puts?
So yeah, this is one where I always advocate for traders to like make sure that your first initial idea is consistent throughout all of the building process for your strategy. Mm-hmm. So what does that mean? That means that when I go to sell that future and it's $78 times 100, so all small exchange futures have the $100 multiplier, just like options in stocks and ETFs. So knowing that I'm short this thing at 78 times 100, that's $7,800. I need to make sure that I'm selling puts in a market that is at least lower than 78, probably closer to like 30, 40, 50, because I want to be under hedged. Because once again, the idea is stock market crash. So the last thing I want to do is sell SM75 at 78 and then sell a put in a stock ETF that's at like 150, they both go lower. I was right on the stock market crash, but I am actually underwater because my exposure from that short put is larger than my futures position. So I looked at the sector ETFs, Mikey, and I looked at one that I think is really quite perfect for this given situation, XLE. You've got energy stocks, and keep in mind that energy stocks make up a fifth of the SM75 index. Mm-hmm. So I can get short the stock market, five sectors of the stock market with SM75. And I can go to XLE, which right now is about a $50 ETF, and I can sell puts in there. And I use that 70 cent number because monthly puts in XLE around the 20 or 30 delta are trading around 70 to 80 cents, very realistic. And I can under hedge with that in mind, that if the stock market crashes, if we get back to where we started the year, here, if we lose that 30% gain that we've seen in the stock market, I'll be out 500 bucks from my XLE short put, but I'll be up 1500 from my SM75 short. So I still profit from that that stock market crash. Did I get the full profit? No, but if that crash doesn't happen here in August, then I offset my position by 70 bucks, and same with September and so on. It's the same idea as reducing cost basis with a covered call here, but you're going to the efficient futures, Mikey, and you're under hedging with XLE, which right now is a smaller stock price and something that's undervalued. You can see here in that red line, not seeing as much upside as the stock market at large. So for a bunch of different reasons, this pairing works for me right now in shorting the stock market.
I love that. That is so ingenious to find something that is sitting at an appropriate price level in XLE. You're about 30% hedged here. You know, you lost 500 on the XLE, you gained 1500 on the stock there, and you could actually flip it completely on the reverse and do it as a covered call as well. So a ton of flexibility with this strategy. Very cool.
Absolutely, man. Yeah, thanks for hanging out here. Always fun to hang out with you here on Fridays. I see that intern Glenn just showed up with the salad, so I'll let you get out of here. Of course, it's usually Pizza Fridays here, but our CEO is actually out of the office today, so all of the millennials and Gen Zers opted to go with salads because we're a weird bunch. We're putting our salad in our fanny pack thing and put the tie-dye t-shirt on and just having a ball here, right?
Absolutely. We're living young and fast over here. We got our electric scooters and trying to save the planet one salad at a time.
We'll see what happens with all of that. Mikey, thanks so much. Everybody, thanks for watching. We got Splash into Futures coming up next. Stuff is on the move here. I wouldn't be surprised if Pete and I could cook up a couple of trades going into the weekend. So hang out for that. Thanks for watching, everybody.